Hi everyone. I'm so excited to be making this video. I'm going to be talking about the all new Flipgrid experience, digging into a little overview of the educator dashboard, which has just been made a little bit simpler. So when you go to Flipgrid and you log in, as always, it's logging me into my groups tab, which is where you want to start. You also have the topics tab. Something that's different is you can't add a topic anymore that is not part of a group. So each of your topics need to be part of one of your groups. So my recommendation is to make sure that you start with groups. If you're starting a new school year, then go ahead and just start a new group for the year like this. Go over to the top right, add a new group. Here you would add the name, and then you'll probably want to just use the email or domain option. That's easiest. You can just put in your school domain. So what that means is all of our email addresses are our names at bullis.org at my school. And so all I do is put at bullis.org here. And by doing that, anybody whose email ends in @bullis.org will be able to log in. So when it says email, you don't need to put every single person's email, just whatever is the domain, which is at the end of the email. Now, if at some point in the year you're doing a collaboration with another school, say it's @schooldistrict.edu is how their emails are. So there's our name @schooldistrict.edu, for example. You would just put that in as the ending. And then that would mean all your students would have access to the grid and you could collaborate with another school district. So you can put in more than one domain if you need to. I'm just going to do it for my school here and then create group. All right, so now my group is ready. You don't really need to copy this link because usually I just share the topic link to get students directly to whatever topic. Now, you will see a just sample intro. If you want to use that, you can use it. You can press the edit button to edit it, but I'm going to just show you how to make a topic of your own because you probably have an idea in mind. So let's go ahead and add a topic, and here is where you're going to leave your prompt. So really, that's the thing. Groups are like your folder, like your whole class, and then your topic is the prompt for your specific assignment. Okay, so think of groups as like the big folder and then topics as all the assignments that you're going to put in that folder. So go ahead and leave a title and a description. And then what you can do is you can add some topic media. And so if you have like an attachment that you want students to read something, you could leave that there. You could import an image if you want to pull in an image as like the header for your topic here. You can also create a video, which I really like to do a lot of times to show students maybe an example of what I want them to do. Just give them some more instruction. If you want them to be reading an article and you want to record a little video of your own to them, what I do is just put the article, read this article in the actual topic prompt because you can just hyperlink and then paste it in just like that. And then this will be a hyperlink for students. So I'll show you how that works. Now I'm going to show you an example using the camera so you can record your own little video to students. So if you just press that, it's going to open up the Flipgrid camera and you can record your own little video here, just like students would be recording their video. So you can use any of the effects, any of the filters, all the good stuff that students have, and we'll talk about the camera a little bit more in a bit when I focus more on the camera and show you some of the exciting backdrops and what you can do with that. All right, but let's go ahead and just create a quick little video here. Hi class, so this is going to be your assignment. I'm giving you some details. I want to remind you to first, make sure that you are doing whatever I'm saying. Second point, don't forget about whatever. And finally, whatever I have to say. All right, so let's complete this video by going to the next step. Looks great. You can snap a new selfie or just select a frame. So maybe I want one at the end where I have all three points up. And now I have my assignment, I have the prompt with the hyperlinked article, I have a little bit of media here, And then I can choose how long I want students to have to record their response. So maybe I want it to be 2 minutes 30. It can be up to 10 minutes. Caution you against using 10 minutes unless you want to watch 10 minutes of each student's video. Just saying. If you want to go over to settings to get some more settings, you can do that. One change here is that this used to be called video moderation and now it's called approve member activity. So if you want things to stay hidden until you actually approve them, then you would toggle this on. So if it's toggled off, then everything, as soon as students record, will just show up on the grid, which is normally what I see teachers doing. But sometimes you want to turn on approve member activity. One instance that you might want to do that is if you want to have a private conversation, so you want students to never be able to see their peers, but you just want their videos to be turned into you, then I would turn that on. Another is if you're doing a sensitive topic or something that's really big school-wide and you want to be able to watch the videos and approve them before the rest of the class can see them, you can turn this on. So I'm going to toggle it on just so we can talk about it. Then comments, if you want students to be able to leave comments back. They can be video and text, video only, text only, or no comments whatsoever. I like video and text. Then there's more options. I'm really not going to talk about these because they're pretty intuitive. You can figure out what they are, but you have the response. You have some camera giving them some options there. And then a guest password is not something that you normally will need to toggle on. That's only needed if you're inviting, for example, families. But I'm not going to talk about that in this video. Go ahead and save. And now this is my topic link that I'm going to give students. So I'm going to copy that just to show you what it looks like. So that would bring students right to my topic. It tells them it's a moderated topic. They can watch my video by pressing on it just like that. And then they can press the button to add their own response. Let me go back over to my educator dashboard. Now over here, I will see videos come in as they are recorded. Let me go back to the beginning just to show you how to get back there, or if you forgot to assign it, how to get that link. So you would find it in either your groups or it was my most recent topic, so it'll be up at the top like this. And so I could click on it to get more information, or if I just needed to get that share link again, I can just press the share button right here and copy that link. All right, so that's how you can get that link after the fact. You can always click on it, and that's how you can watch all the videos as they come in. You also have the share button available here. And if you want to see what the students would see, all you do is click on member view, and that pops it open from the student view. Okay, so the member view means that student view. All right, so if you do have this moderated topic turned on, then when students submit their video, you will see by default it's hidden. Now you can watch the videos from your educator dashboard by just clicking on it. If you look from the student view, you'll see that none show up yet. But on the educator dashboard, you can see both are hidden. You can just press the play button to view the video, and you can go down here and you can actually leave a private comment to the student if you want to. So you can go ahead and send that and your student would get a notification that they got a comment on their video, whether or not it's hidden. So even if you keep it hidden and you go ahead and you add this private text comment, students would be able to see that through the email notification they would get. It's the easiest way probably for them to get to it. If you want this video to show up for the entire class, you can change it from hidden to active either there, or if we go back, you can also do it here. So I can go from hidden to active just like that. And now if I go back over to the student view, you'll see that now that video shows up for the full class to see. However, the comment is only going to show up privately. So this is showing up on my end because I am Stacy and I'm signed in as myself, but only the student would be able to view the comment themselves because it's private. If you want the whole class to see the comment, you can do that too by adding a comment and choosing that it is a public comment. So there's no more educator feedback, but instead you can just leave a comment and leave it as private or public. Oh, and you can also record it as a video comment. It doesn't have to be a text comment. So you can press record and do that same thing and make that video either private or public. If at any time you decide that you don't want this topic moderated anymore, you just want everybody's to show up immediately, you can always go back and you can edit the topic
and go back to your settings and you can uncheck that, update the topic. Anything that was already submitted, you are going to have to make active. If you need to do that in bulk, you can just click on the check marks here and then go to actions here and you can activate, and that would activate all of the responses. All right, I think that's going to be it for this video. I hope it was helpful. I hope you enjoy using Flipgrid this year. There's so many ways that students can creatively express their understandings, verbalize their thinking process. So much excitement. I hope you enjoy it. Bye.